This evening I have talked about this circuit, and I wanted to show how two coupled coils can act and where their peak resonance is. I wanted to try to make an IF filter that did not succeed. The bandwidth was approximately 1.45 kilocycles, but well, that points me to another idea to show how a normal 4.55 kilohertz filter, ceramic filter, works. That has to work, of course, in the 10 kilo cycle band, and then I mean 10 kilo cycle bandwidth, or 7 kilo cycles, that's also good anyway. You see some of them, of these IF filters that I have used in the past anyway. Mitsumi filter, here another Mitsumi filter, here a Toko filter. Toko and Mitsumi were the popular brands that made IF filters in the 1980s and 1990s, etc., etc., and even up to now, 2021. Here is the setup. We have here my test oscillator that works between, say, approximately, in this case, 100 kilohertz and 1 megahertz. And here is the schematic. Like I told earlier, the same things apply to a coil filter and a ceramic filter. When you want to make give it a critical coupling with a small bandwidth, you need a small capacitor value here, say 22 picofarad, 50 picofarad, that's the range, and also here 22 picofarad, perhaps 10 picofarad here, or even 10 picofarad here, that's the range. Could go to 47 picofarad. In that case, you get a sharp bandwidth, and also with a ceramic filter. And that ceramic filter is here at the moment. And here we have again all these other ceramic filters. 4.55 kilocycles, 4.32 kilocycles. These filters were tested on 4.55 kilocycles, etc. The most important thing is that when you want to use such a filter in an IF amplifier, in general, the best idea is that it has a ground electrode. That's here. It's a middle electrode. Here. So input, output, ground. And you can also see that here, input, output, ground. So let's look at what this circuit can bring. And this is a test setup. It's very important to tell that such a test setup here, when you connect such a IF ceramic filter to a test oscillator, like I do it here, the test oscillator at its output here, output, has a certain output impedance, and also the scope to which that filter is connected has an input impedance, though in general that input impedance is extremely low in case of an oscilloscope. And then I mean a normal oscilloscope, not a cheap one. Or oscilloscopes, say bought for 30 euros on AliExpress or whatever. A normal oscilloscope has an extremely high input on its input, and that is 1 megaohm, and in general a few picofarads. So that damps in a certain way, or it has an effect on such a crystal filter. Anyway, that doesn't mean that we have to despair, because the whole setup gives us very, very good information about how such a crystal filter works. And I will show it now. This is the signal sent into that filter. And here we have the counter. And now I'm going to change the frequency to the filter. You can see a very substantial drop down. And here there is a peak resonance. And here it drops down again. 454, it drops down. Here is the peak resonance. And I have to say, my counter does not give the right values. That's kind of a shame, but anyway, I don't know why my counter is a little bit, gets a little bit obsolete, but anyway, 455 kilocycles, that's good. And here we have that peak. 459, and a drop down again. So I only wanted to show here this peak resonance. And when you have a good scope and a good counter, don't worry, this is what it's all about. You have to search the peak resonance where such a crystal works. And again, you can get it more critical by using a tiny input capacitor or a tiny output capacitor, etc., etc. So that was more or less all to tell. You can surely repeat this experiment when you have an oscillator that works around the frequency that the crystal has. So the ceramic filter has, say it's 455 kilocycles, and when you have an oscillator that goes below, say 20 kilocycles below 455 kilocycles and 20 kilocycles above 455 kilocycles, you can do this test. And this is, say, the my test oscillator. The circuit is on YouTube. Of course, you don't have to make this, in fact, quite complicated circuit. As long as you have a test oscillator that works between 440 and 460 kilohertz, and then connect the output of such a ceramic filter to your scope and counter. And my Chinese scope also has a counter, frequency counter inserted, so that's extremely good. Let's look again what happens here. Nothing happens. I don't know why, but anyway, I think the whole video was good to show all the different properties. Well, let's do it again. I have to not turn the fine tuning knob, but the coarse tuning knob, and that shows that we have here an enormous peak. Anyways, thanks for watching. This reverse 462 has everything to do with the input and the output coupling of that ceramic filter, so that it shows a somewhat too high frequency. Doesn't matter as long as all the IF filters in an IF amplifier are tuned to the same frequency. That can be tested in this way.